Okay, so welcome to this question right here. We got a 7 over 11 multiplied by radical 1250. So the denominator outside of radical, you can actually just keep it as it is, and you can write out in terms like a fraction like this, right? And you just have to leave it alone, just for now. And the 1250, because the number gets too big, so what I'll suggest is actually figure out the prime factorization for this guy. So let's do the 1250 on the side, and let's go ahead, let's do the 5, okay? So if you divide the number by 5, you get a 250 right here, okay? And then if you do it one more time, you're gonna get yourself other numbers like the 50 here, and divide by 5, you get yourself a 10, and if you divide yourself by 5 again, you get yourself a 2. So the 1250 is just 5 times 5 times 5 times 5 times 2, right? So the trick is, if you're doing the square root, that means this root number here is a 2, right? So for every pair of identical number, in this case we have a pair of 5 here and then a pair of 5 here, they can be taken out from the radical sign and put in the front. So now the question now becomes, there's a 5 in the front because there was a pair here, and there's another 5 that you just took out from the radical. And you're just left with the 2 inside of the radical, okay? And you just have to work out the math. If you do the math correctly, which is 7 over 11 times 5 times 5 and then times the 2, you get yourself 175 over 11, and there is your root 2. And that's the end for this question. Thanks for watching.